past 2 years, I have gone to West Virginia on service trips, and I currently spend time doing furniture and food deliveries in Brockton with my brother's keeper. The reason why I like doing service is because, as selfish as it sounds, the way it makes me feel when I'm making a difference. To me, nothing is more satisfying than giving someone a new couch they can sit on or building a new set of stairs they can walk on and realizing that you've just physically added something to their lives. I felt that going to Jamaica was just going to be a continuation of the service I was already doing at home. However, when I got there, I could not have been more wrong. When our group first arrived at Jacob's Ladder, it immediately felt different than any type of service I had done before. During the day, everyone, us and the residents, all were having so much fun. Whether it was dancing to the same song 5 times in a row, drawing a picture, or getting tapped over and over by some of the residents, it seemed like there was no way you couldn't just be happy. However, when the day was over and we were in the chapel at night, it was hard for me to recognize the true difference I was making. I couldn't stop thinking about the fact that even though we were having so much fun now, in less than a week, we would be leaving and all the residents we just met, and we would be leaving all the residents we just met, and another group would be coming in to do the same thing and form the same relationships. I started to let this get in the way of my experience because I began to fixate on the fact that I had to leave something tangible in Jamaica in order to make the trip have a purpose. So, for the next 2 days, while many of the other missionaries were playing and having fun with the residents, my focus, which was supposed to be on the residents, switched to building a concrete ramp. I put so much effort into building this ramp, which, looking back, was the stupidest thing I had done. It was not worth losing the ability to walk after being in a squat for so long or being completely covered in concrete. Even though I placed so much of an emphasis on building that ramp, and believing it was a mistake, I do not regret it, because it helped me to not only realize what the point of our trip was about, but it helped to show to me the true meaning of service. It was not until Friday night, when we had to say goodbye to the residents that we had just met, that I began to see this. Even though I had wasted 2 days making the concrete ramp, I was still able to bond with one of the residents named Dina. Me, Karen, and Vinny had become really close with her, talking about things from what going on a boat was like to how Vinny and her don't need a girlfriend or boyfriend in their life. Well, having to say bye to Dina was really hard because I knew I would probably never see her again. This wasn't the true moment that changed my view of the trip. The moment that really hit me hardest that night was when Ryan Donahue was just talking to me in the dining room. We were surrounded already by pretty much all of the girls bawling their eyes out because they had to say goodbye. And all of a sudden, he too just started crying, saying how much he was going to miss this week and how much he loved everyone. The fact that he was crying was not the thing that shocked me, mainly because I always felt he was a little soft. The main thing that shocked me was how he said he loved everyone. That is when I realized that even though I wasn't going to Jamaica to give them a couch or build them a set of stairs, we were there to just give them love. Looking back at all the connections between us and the residents, whether it was James and Melissa, Jack and Damien, or Caitlin and Elvis, they were all connections of love. Our whole week in Jamaica was filled completely with this love, not only sharing it with the residents, but with each other as well. Every single one of us who went on this trip came from a different background, playing different sports, having different friends, and being in different grades. But after a week of being together and sharing all this love, we truly became friends. Like, I don't even think most of the seniors probably knew who I was until. Taking all this into perspective, I now realize that this is what service truly is. Not giving or making someone something, or spending 2 days making a concrete ramp, but just loving them. The back of our CSP shirt has the quote by Mother Teresa that says, "You cannot do great things, only small things with great love." In order to serve and do God's work, you don't need to go on a plane to another country, but you simply just need to love others.
James. So coming in. into the trip, I had no idea what I was going to expect. Like, I had no idea if I was going to be okay with being in a house with the same people for a week with no internet. You know, like, I had no idea if I was going to be able to interact with the residents because, like, they all had disabilities and I never really experienced that before. So getting on the plane, I was super nervous. I don't know if it was like the nerves or the food, because like, I just puked everywhere. And when we landed in Jamaica, I was thinking to myself, I was like, oh, the week started off bad. This might just be like an awful week. But the second we pulled in to Jacob's Ladder, which is where we stayed, I knew that everything was going to be okay, because as the bus drove down the road, all the residents started running and like, they already loved us, I guess, because like, we didn't even know them. They were like dancing with us and having a good time, even though we had been there for like 35 seconds. So the relationships we made with missionaries and with the residents are some of the most real things that I've ever experienced. Like, over 5 hours of like silent reflection with Vinny, Jack, Ryan, and Isaiah, we kind of realized that like, life happens outside of the internet and on your phone, and drama outside like high school or whatever. And like, the experience we had in Jamaica was so real because we escaped what like distracts us the most. Like, it's kind of ironic that I'm talking about how my phone runs the world and my notes are on my phone. And like, my experience in Jamaica was that like, in order to really experience life, you have to like take a step back and realize that life isn't in your phone. Like, sure, all your friends are on your phone, you're talking to them, but like, the stuff that you need to really appreciate is outside of that. And that's what I got.
Choosing to put effort into these things is what love truly looks like. So, if you haven't noticed, the main point of my witness is the message of love. So as I was figuring out what I would say today, I remembered a Bible verse that really stood out to me. Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. This is undoubtedly one of the most well-known verses of the Bible, but my perspective of it was completely changed when I was in 8th grade. I've gone to Catholic school my whole life, and on Thursdays our pastor, Father Hickey, would teach religion. And the first and only homework assignment he ever gave to us was to replace all of those loves and all of those ifs with the name of a person we know it. How we experienced love on this trip was so special, and I'm sure any missionary could stand up here and replace those words with the name of a resident or worker of mustard seed, or a chaperone, or a fellow missionary. So here's my version. Gabe is patient, Joe is kind, Mikey does not envy, Emily does not boast, May is not proud, Robert does not dishonor others, Karen is not self-seeking, Evan is not easily angered, Morgan keeps no record of wrong, Austin does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Melissa always protects. Chrisigay always trusts. Denovan always hopes. Damien always perseveres. God never fails. The point of me replacing names was not to leave anyone out, because to be quite honest, I could have put any missionary or any resident into that verse. But this witness is to remind us how easy it is to do it ourselves. So if you find yourself able to replace all of those words with the people in your life, you should consider yourself pretty lucky. The love we experience is not a feeling that is fleeting. Again, it is a choice, and we must let it continue to affect our lives. The blessings that touch our heart are immeasurable when we make that choice to see them. As Spellman students, we need to continue to choose to live without fear, to let what is learned here not be forgotten, and make the decision to choose to live every day with the message to just love.
Oh. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong.
Sometimes I lay under the moon, I thank God I'm breathing, and I pray don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason.
Yeah.
Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around, because children will play.